What's good, sneaker fam? Welcome back to Our Sneakers. Before I start, I do want to say that I'm still selling my shirt. It is on my website. As you can see, it has the Our Sneakers logo on the front, and then it has the three shoes on the side. It has a V2 on top, Ultra Boost in the middle, and then a Jordan 1 in the bottom. Each shirt is $20. You can go ahead and find the link down below in the description. Pre-orders do end on New Year's Day, so make sure you get them before it ends. Next up, I do want to say that I'm still raffling off the Jordan 1 top 3. The size is 7.5, as you guys can see right here. 7.5 right there. Each raffle ticket is $1, and you can go ahead and find the link to that down in the description below as well. Right now, there's about 75 entries in, so make sure you get them while they last. Anyways, moving on with today's sneakers, I do want to talk about my top 5 sneakers of 2016. I wasn't going to do top 10, but I figured that video would be too long, it'd be too many, and it'd be too easy, so I wanted to narrow it down and make it a little harder for me to choose. So to start off, the fifth shoe is the Kith and Adidas Ultra Boost mid-top collab, and since I don't own this shoe, I will put a picture of it up here. And the reason I put this on my list because I feel like it's the collab of the year. Ronnie Fieg or Kith as a brand, they're just so big and they're so good on quality that it's amazing that they collab with Adidas, which is another really big brand. And to come up with this shoe and this silhouette, it's a brand new silhouette as well, so it's really crazy. I really haven't seen the shoe in person, but in pictures, I can tell that the primer looks very comfortable, and then it has like that, I don't know what you want to call it material, but on the side it has like that plastic, I guess. So it keeps your foot in, and so your foot doesn't wiggle too much, because the primer does give you a lot of slack. And then of course you have the Ultra Boost, which is really comfortable. And it's a perfect shoe right now for the winter, since it is a mid-top shoe. And knowing how well Kith does with their collabs, and how well their materials are, I know the shoe does have a really great structure, and it does have good materials as well. So that is a very quality shoe, which is why it's at number 5. Moving on to number 4, I did choose to put the Adidas Futurecraft at this spot, just because it is a brand new shoe for Adidas. It's a new innovation, and I feel like it's a turning point for the brand themselves. I feel like they can do so much with this technology for 2017. I don't know what yet, but I know Adidas has something up their sleeve, and they will be coming up with some really cool stuff. Not only that, but usually when companies come out with new innovations, it's not always the best looking, but this shoe also looks great. I wish I had a pair to show you guys on camera, but unfortunately I don't. But I can tell you that Adidas is gonna go crazy with this. Up next on the list, which is number 3, I did put the Triple Black NMDR1. And this is the pair that is limited to 500 pairs. It has a primate upper, kind of with like the camo lines on it. And then it has the black painted boost. And this is number 3 on the list just because I love the silhouette, I love how limited it is, and I love the way they released it especially. Moving on to number 2 on the list, I did put the NMD Burgundy Human Race. And the reason this is number 2 is just because this shoe is beautiful, it's absolutely beautiful. I'm in love with the color burgundy first of all, or garnet, whatever you want to call it, more like the FSU colors are like my favorite colors. And which is why I love this shoe a lot. Not only that, but the Japanese printing on top of the shoe, really, it's really, really dope. I like it more than the regular English letters that say like human or race or whatever it is that they say. But the Japanese letters is a super nice touch to it. Another thing I like about the shoe is how exclusive it is. It's only limited to family and friends. From what I know of, I'm not sure if they release them to the public at all or anything. And not only that, for being a limited shoe, it's also a very comfortable shoe. And it's using one of Adidas' most innovative products. Last but not least, you guys can probably guess what shoe this is. Of course, it has to be the Nike Air Max. This shoe has to be the best shoe on everybody's list. Because come on, we've been waiting for this shoe forever. We all know it. I mean, even though if you can't even pick it up, we all know we were waiting for the technology. It's a super dope shoe. The fact that it laces by itself is already dope itself. And then, of course, they have to put it on a Nike Air Mag. That's a wrap. It's a super dope shoe. It's also a super expensive shoe. But then again, the release was pretty dope, and it was a really cheap way to getting it. So all you had to do was put in raffle tickets. And it's at a random. So that's, I just put in one because I felt like if I was meant to have the shoe, that one raffle ticket that was mine would have been picked out of the millions that were probably submitted. But it wasn't meant to be, so I didn't get the shoe. And of course, the Nike Air Mag is a legendary shoe, so that's why it's such a big release. Last but not least, it is a turning point for Nike. Since it is a new technology for their brand, I'm pretty sure they'll be implementing this into basketball sneakers, running sneakers, and so on. And this is probably the biggest thing for Nike this year, because Adidas has been killing them. But I still got love for Nike, so don't get me wrong on that aspect. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to have any of these shoes, but I just feel like these were the top 5 shoes of the year. I wish I could have them to show you. I wish I could have them in my collection as well, but as you guys may know, these shoes are all pretty hard to get your hands on. And even if you could get your hands on them, you gotta pay a good price for them. But if you did enjoy the video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Also, don't forget to subscribe. We are trying to get to 10,000 by February 11th with your SneakerCon for Lauderdale, which I will be at. If you're at that SneakerCon, make sure you say what's up. I will have a table. But until then, make sure you stay woke. Our sneakers signing out.
You're listening to
Peace.